Now let's solve 2x squared plus 4x minus 6 by completing the square. And my first step will be to factor out this 2. Every time that you have a number in front of the squared variable, you want to factor it out. But you don't need to factor it out from the last number here. The last number you can just toss over to the other side of the equal sign. So 2x squared divided by 2 is x squared. 4x divided by 2 is just 2x. And like I said, I'll just add 6 to both sides of the equation so that I can take the 6, the negative 6 over there. Just positive 6 now. Great. Now I want to add a number here that will complete the square. 4x squared plus 2x, making this whole thing a perfect square trinomial. What will that number be? We're going to take the 2. We will divide it by 2. We always divide it by 2 regardless of this number. The fact that it's a 2 here as well is just a coincidence. And we're going to square it. So 2 over 2, 1. Squared is 1. So I will add a 1 here. And normally, I would add a 1 here as well. But because of this 2, I need to put a 2 times that 1. If this was 5, that would also be a 5. Right? Because we need to balance. And this 1 is actually a 2 in disguise. Because if we were to expand, that'd be a 2. So just take my word for it. Put a whatever number is here, there as well, and multiply it by the third term, or the third number. Great. Now we can factor this. Factor this whole thing. And we have x plus a number squared. What will that number be? We can just take this number and divide it by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. Okay, over on the right hand side we have 6 plus 2, because 2 times 1 is just 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. Great. Now we can just divide both sides by 2. So x plus 1 squared is just 4, because 8 divided by 2 is 4. Then we can take the square root from both sides of the equation. On this side we put a plus and plus or minus root 4 in, because we're taking the square root of a constant. These guys are going to now cancel out, because the square root of a number squared cancels out the square. So x plus 1 is equal to plus or minus 2, because the root of 4 is just 2. And it can subtract 1 from both sides of the equation. And x will be negative 1 plus or minus 2. So that will give us two answers. The first one being negative 1 plus 2, which is 1, and negative 1 minus 2, which is negative 3. That's it. So x is equal to negative 3 and positive 1.